laughing, got friends, and also like playing music, sitting in the corner, watching them girls. Yeah, that's what I love doing for fun. Hi, my name is Loyiso Mqubeni. I live in township of Khayelitsha in Cape Town, which is in South Africa. I'm an enriched student in one of the Edmund and Rice Justice Desks. I like the theme group because I can express my feelings. Like, even when I'm sad, I go to the drama group, and then that is where I find inner peace, I can say so. That is where I can find inner peace. There's a lot of stigma with people living with HIV in Khayelitsha. They treat you like a different person, whereas you're not a different person, you're just a normal person, but living with a disease. Sometimes when like you go out with friends, they will like, we don't want to hang with you. There's that person inside of you, that loving person, that caring person, that wants to be loved and nurtured.
With youth is, they speak their mind and they very curious. They ask questions. And what I learned from them is that if you're honest with them, they will be honest with you. And if you treat them with respect, they will treat you with respect. My name is Boyiso Angelina Ntsadu. I'm a general counselor and I'm an HIV counselor at the Desmond Tutu HIV Foundation. Sometimes I find that the communities are not that supportive towards people that are HIV positive. Some of our clients here get tested HIV positive. It's not easy for them to disclose to their families. And even if they have to go for ARVs, they don't want to go to their local clinic where they are because they don't want to be seen.
People in my community, they are afraid of getting tested. They are embarrassed of going to the clinic because in clinic there are two sections. There's a youth section and then there's also an adult section. So if I am a male going to the youth section, then it's obvious why I'm going to the youth section. So like they are embarrassed of going there because they will be labeled. They are not tested, so it's kind of hard for them to get the medication.
Some of them are staying by themselves, so they have to find means and ways to support themselves. The financial conditions that people deal with here is that they're mainly supported by their main partners. Here you will find out they in relationships with men older than them. It's not easy for them to get work.
There are lots of unemployed youth. The jobs are scarce and then poverty strikes in, and then that affects the family as a whole. And also it affects the person living with the disease so that he or she struggles to get the medication from the clinic. If they're not available, then it means he or she can't do anything about that. There's no plan B for her or him. Sometimes I go to the clinic to get the medication and then I find it not available, and then sometimes I do go to the clinic and find it available. It's like that situation is tough. Sometimes we find it and sometimes we don't. If I skip a day, that is very bad for my health. If it can be affordable, like all the time it can be there, availability must be there, then we can be safe, we can be right.
To those who are living with HIV, I would say, it is not your fault. You didn't ask for it. We need to help each other in standing together to teach each other that there is HIV out there and it won't go away if we don't stand together fighting against it.
To all the young people around the world, do not be embarrassed, do not be afraid. It's your choice, it's your status. Go out there and do well. Go get tested. Know your status because I know mine. And I've tested and I'm healthy. I'm just like you. I'm not different from you. It's just that I'm living with a disease. The problem is my rights are not protected.
Never give up on your life. Continue fighting, continue spreading the word and say, I am HIV positive and I'm proud and I'll be living my life the way I'm supposed to.
Let us all unite and stand together. If we can't support each other, then no one will support each other. Let us go out there and show them that we are the youth of the world.